Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm coming at you with my current favorites. I don't do monthly favorites because I tend to forget what I'm using for the month just because I have a very high-paced type of lifestyle. And I'm very, very forgetful most of the time, so I'm sorry about that, but I will do a current favorites like video every couple of months or so. But I'm gonna say that this is like my summer favorites because I've been using these products crazy. So the first of all, I will go with makeup and then move on to fashion. So the first one here, now I love Kat Von D, and I am just so grateful that she has a makeup line that really works for, you know, people that have sensitivity and people who, you know, love artwork as well. And I love these two products here. These have been my lifesaver for this whole, like, almost whole summer. I have, like, Kat Von D came out with this about 3 weeks or 3 weeks ago or something. And this is the Locket Foundation. This is just, it's the same formula, but she just repackaged it in a different design, and I really, really like this design. It's cleaner, it's simple, it's very beautiful. It looks like art. I am in the color Light 42 Neutral, so this is the lightest color that they feature. I have very, very, very light skin, and, you know, this is me tanned, and I wear this. So when it comes to winter, fall, winter, when you know, I'm not going outside that much, this is actually a little bit dark for me, but it's the best shade I can find and the best foundation that's formulated that won't irritate my skin. And I have very sensitive, oily, acne-prone skin, and this does not activate it at all. It actually helps calming down my skin, believe it or not. I guess it's because it doesn't have, like, alcohol and parabens and stuff like that. So it is very, very safe for sensitive skin. And it claims that it has 24-hour wear. I would say it has 6 to 10 hour wear. After that, it just, like, especially with oily skin, it doesn't melt off, it just disappears. But not to the extreme where you don't see any more foundation, but, like, the nose area, the T-zone, and maybe, like, the cheeks, it will, like, kind of disappear or rub off. But it is the best foundation I have found on the market. I think it's better than Dior makeup and Chanel and, you know, all those really, really high-end brands. And this is cruelty-free, so that's really, really cool about her products. And the next one that goes with the foundation is her foundation brush, Locket Foundation Brush. This is pretty new. It came out, like, 2 weeks ago, I think, in Canada. So I believe, like, in the States and other countries came out earlier, but I really love this. This is number 10. This is her foundation brush, and it's a really, really compact brush. This brush has a very nice weight to it. The handle is really, really easy to hold. The bristles are really compact. It doesn't feel very loose. It actually feels kind of like a beauty blender in a way. I actually pat my face like a beauty blender. I don't use beauty blenders because I don't like cleaning beauty blenders. And I find that cleaning brushes is a lot more easier and sanitary. And this brush does wonders. It looks like I airbrushed my foundation on. And it's actually a pretty reasonable price considered to other price tags, and this is synthetic hair. And I like how it has kind of like this edging here of the brush, so you can get at every, like, little corner, specifically like in the nose area or like in between the nose and the eyebrow. It really, really is amazing. So next one here is from Benefit. And this here is the Ready Set Brow. I absolutely love this. This will set your eyebrow coloring or your shade in into your eyebrow so it doesn't budge, and also it makes your eyebrow hairs look like or it just doesn't make your eyebrows look so drawn in, and actually makes it look a lot more natural. And you can wear this even without coloring your eyebrows. I prefer to have drawn my eyebrows just because my eyebrows are super super light. But if you have thicker brows and you just need to shape them and have the hair stay in place, this will really really do wonders for your eyebrows. So it comes in a clear gel form. And on one side here, the side, it has short bristles just so you can comb through your eyebrows. And then the longer side will just set your eyebrows in. It actually fluff your eyebrows up a little bit just to make it look like your eyebrows aren't glued to your face. And yeah, this will keep your brows like drawn, like the shape of your brows drawn in or stay in place all day long. And then the next one here is the highbrow. Sorry, I did not sharpen this yet, but it's a cream form, and what you basically do, or it basically does, is it gives your eyebrow bone here like some extra dimension to your face, and actually adds that like that definition, the I guess highlighting to your brow without doing the whole like I don't know what you call it, but the contouring of the face per se. This actually helps give your eyebrows that nice finished look on the bottom of your brows. I use this not every day, but I have been using this a lot for days when I have not been having good eyebrow days. Or actually, like days are like for the no makeup looking days. So, and yeah, they've been a lifesaver. So, I will, like, when the time comes to repurchase them, I will definitely like repurchase them again. So, the next one here is from Chanel. These two here are only the Chanel products that I've been loving to death this summer. And it is, first of all, the Chanel Small Eyeshadow Brush. So it's just a real hair fluffy small brush. I have my eyes are pretty small, so it's kind of hard to really get in there, but this really does the job. I use it. This is like the actual one brush I use. It's my all-in-one brush. I use it to blend. I use it just to put one shade in, or even just to shade contour my eyes with the V, or and even like on the lower lash, I'll put it there as well and smudge my eyeliner. It does everything, and I absolutely love this. This is the number 15 small eyeshadow brush, and the price of this isn't that bad. You really do get your money's worth out of this brush, and I actually plan on buying another one of this brush because it is that good. And then the second Chanel makeup I have here is the Soleil Tan de Chanel, and it's basically just a cream bronzer. I think I have the lightest shade because I don't want to look too tanned and cakey. This just gives my face like gives me a little bit more shape, dimension, some contouring as you will, but basically more color for the summer because I am very 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 light skinned. And also because it's cream, it does not it doesn't break me out or anything with my acne. Okay, and the next one here is from Boscia. This is the exfoliating peel gel. I actually just bought this like 2 days ago, but this definitely gonna be in my skin routine for a very very long time until my skin says no more. But I really really love this stuff. So I've like with acne comes dry flaky skin as well. So it's like oily skin is very very tough to deal with, but this really does actually help moisturize and exfoliate my skin without the burning sensation that you get from exfoliators, like with the little plastic beads in your face and you're supposed to rub it. This does not do that. So basically what you do is you make sure that you clean your face, wash your face normally, and you have to have both your hands and your face completely dry. So then you just put like a pump or two on your hands, pat your face, and then once you have a lot of product on, and then you just start rubbing your face, and then you'll start seeing your dead skin kind of like ball up. And at first it's kind of gross, but it really helps eliminate the flaky skin. I used to get it all around here, and ever since I used this, I don't have that feel, that like annoying flaky skin anymore when I put my foundation on, or even throughout the day. I've actually felt that my skin has felt a lot more softer and just a lot more moisturized, and it's kind of weird, but this really did the work for me. So I highly recommend this to people who have dry, flaky skin on their face and doesn't want like the harsh rubbing effect. This is really, really, really gentle on your face, and it is a gel, so it's amazing for acne prone skin as well. Okay, so the next one here, and I want to just apologize for like the look of my nails. They don't look, you know, amazing. I've actually like taking a break from the nail salon, so I've been actually I've fallen back in love with my Christian Louboutin nail polishes, and this here is the new nail polish color. I'm actually wearing it. It's called Miss Mars, and basically it's just a silver, like a chrome finish, like a silver, and apparently chrome nails are in nowadays. So, and I really, really like this. There was times when my like nails like this would happen, it would just chip off, and I would just reapply this on, and it looks like nothing ever chipped. But because this has been a week old, and I've been kind of lazy redoing my nails, I will, you know, redo the whole thing again. But I love Christian Louboutin nail polishes. They stay on longer than normal nail polish. They last, I think, like up to a week or so without getting, you know, chipping. They dry super fast, and even though they are really expensive, like $60 for nail polish, it's ridiculous. It's cheaper than going to the nail salon, and this actually helps me kind of stop going to the nail salon. So yeah, really, really love that product. Okay, so the next one here is my YSL Monogram Palladium Ring. So I got this I think in the springtime, so maybe in like March or something, and it's just a simple ring that says YSL just twisted around the finger, and it is, you can't really tell it's YSL unless like you actually know it is YSL, but I think it's really beautiful. It hasn't like tarnished or anything. It's really pretty. It kind of, to me, it looks like antlers like kind of wrapping around my finger, and I kind of like that kind of like wilderness kind of look, I guess you could say. It's really comfortable. It doesn't like jab into my hand or anything. It's kept its shine, and yeah, it's just, it's really pretty too, and it's actually my one and only designer ring. And then next off is this little Longchamp pouch. Just, it's supposed to be like, I guess, for like makeup and everything, but I actually use it to keep my jewelry in when I'm on the go. And I have basically a whole bunch of jewelry in here. My Louis Vuitton bracelet, my Chanel brooch, and my really tangled Alexander McQueen skull necklace, and yeah, that's it. But I really like this because I'm always like either losing my jewelry or misplacing them, So this just keeps all my jewelry in one when I'm on the go. So this is like perfect for traveling. And I got this on sale from Halts like a month or so ago. And I absolutely love this. It fits in almost every handbag, and it tends to get squished a lot, but it doesn't like ruin the shape or anything. It is a little bit dirty at the corners, but it's okay. It's whatever. So the next one here is from Louis Vuitton, and this is my 6-ring key holder in the rose ballerine and monogram print. I really love this little item. It holds all my keys and like travel, like points cards. It's compact. It's actually saved me a lot of like handbag Tetris games. It's totally like headache safe. And yeah, nothing more I can say about this, but it really has kept or helped me with organization within my handbag. And I just love holding this, and I love the little rose ballerine like color and everything. And the little button here has not gotten dirty or anything. I think I showed you guys how I close this, but basically what I do without touching the button, I just line it up with the button underneath, and then I just take it on the sides and just press, and then that's it. And the canvas is really sturdy. The no issues here with this little guy, and I know people have had issues, but I haven't so far. Next ones I actually forgot to show you while I was showing you makeup are the Kitty Kat matte lipsticks. They're a little bit dirty because the packaging is white and it's like a weird like package, but this is it. I have it in 4 colors. First one here is Kitty Purry. Next one is Pink Paws. And then next one is called Sphinx. And the next one is called Maroon Meow. So I'm actually wearing right now Kitty Purry. Like on the bottle, it looks like it's really purple, but really it's more like a not so neutral, but like a purple neutral, I guess you could say. The feelings of these lipsticks are amazing. I say it's actually better than, and you guys know I don't like YSL lipstick or makeup in general, but it has a better staying power. It doesn't like crease into my lips. The staying power is pretty good, and the sticks, like the actual lipsticks, are just your plain simple lipsticks, but they glide on really well. And I will do like a whole nother video on these lipsticks because I don't know, I don't think they're getting as much attention as like I think they should, like other brands are given. But I really love these. The Katy Perry lipsticks range in, I think, 7 colors, I think. But right now I only have 4, and I don't think I'll be purchasing any more other colors because these are the 4 colors that I absolutely loved in her range. So the texture is there, the staying power is amazing. You can actually apply these lipsticks without actually like looking in the mirror. That's how fantastic they are. And yeah, so the next one here I'm gonna show is, now this is kind of embarrassing, but this is the Louis Vuitton like Neverfull MM or Neverfull pouch that it comes with. This is embarrassing, but it's like packed full of just like crap that I'm too lazy to take care of, but I know that it's full of stuff that I need for my handbags. And what I do is I basically just take this out and just drop it into my next handbag that I'm going to be using the next day. I really love using it. Sometimes I'll even take it out and use it as a clutch, but right now I love using it as like an extra little storage bag thing. And I know it's stuffed to the brim. I will not use the zipper obviously to close this up. It won't close. It just won't. But I find that when it's filled up like this, and it creates this kind of like, I don't know, the stretch mark here, and you take this all out, eventually it will like go away, but right now I'm just super lazy right now. So, but I this has really eased the pain or the annoyance of switching bags and taking like an hour to switch out of the bag and clean out the bag. So that's all I'm gonna say about that one. And the next one here, and I will do a review right after this video, is my Louis Vuitton Noué bag here that I got in Japan pre-loved. I have been using this a lot this past summer. It holds, I think, more than my Neverfull MM because the base is so much bigger and the bag is so much taller, and you necessarily don't need to, tighten or, tighten the leather string here. You can just let the bag kind of like sit there like this and kind of have it. That's how I like to wear it a lot. Sometimes I find when I'm like actually going out for longer trips or whatnot, I will just tie it up, cinch it up, and go along with my day. But I love using this. This summer has been really crazy to the point where I haven't been using a lot of small bags lately. Or when I do have small bags, I have to take this with me because it will just hold everything and just end the headaches of handbag Tetris. I can just simply just dump all my things in, and so, and I've been doing that a lot this summer because it's just been super crazy. My boyfriend likes the fact that it holds everything and that it's pretty convenient. So and the wear and tear on this is absolutely amazing. I've actually worn a lot more of this. I will show you in my next video after this review of this handbag. I haven't like really made much buzz about this handbag, but I will now. So stay tuned for that video. And these are my current favorites right now. Let me know in the comments below what your current favorites are. What are your summer beauty must-haves or like life-saving kit? Because all these items I've mentioned here are my summer life-saving stuff. Without this, I don't think I would like, I think I would just go crazy this summer. Like, yeah. I am just thankful that I have these in like right now because I'm going through so much skin breakouts and drama. But yeah, so I won't do like a acne, how to care for acne video because I'm not an expert on it. I just know how to, I don't know, make my acne feel a little bit more comfortable. I don't know, maybe if you want, maybe I can show you guys or make another video about that. Let me know in the comments below, and I'll try my best to get that video up and running. So, thanks guys for watching. I hope you guys have have had a great summer so far. Let me know in the comments below what are your current favorites, and I will see you guys in my next video. Thanks everyone. Bye bye.